Hello, this is Bern, and on today's video, I'm going to share 7 emotional traits that inspire healthy, conscious, masculine, committed men to fall head over heels in love with you. Hello, this is Bern. Welcome to another edition of BernMendez.com, a space where I share with ambitious, conscious and heart-centered women how you can attract the man you want and enter the relationship you crave without the need for gimmicks, manipulation, or silly techniques. If this is your first time here and this type of topic interests you heavily, click the subscribe button to make sure that you're notified of new episodes as they come out. Now, we live in a time where most of society is attempting to tell you that something's broken in you. And especially as it relates to your physical appearance, that something has to shift or change for you to be attractive, for a man to want you and fall in love with you. Whether that's exercise or a specific way of dressing, or maybe the size of your breasts, or maybe your height, or the color of your skin, or how amazing and clear your face is. But what I'm here to say to you is that although physical appearance is important when you connect with a man, it's important for you as well, that it's not the defining factor that will allow him to open his heart and fall in love with you. And because you only have a certain amount of control through nutrition, through exercise on your body, but you really can't change your DNA, my focus today is to help you to pay attention to and embrace certain traits that will make you irresistible to awesome men. Now, before I go on and start sharing the 7 traits, if you want to take the concepts of this video further than I can share on this video, and not just the concept of this video, the concepts of any video you're learning right now, you want to embrace the physical aspect and the emotional aspect of stepping into the being and doing versus just understanding, the first link in the description of this video, when you click on that link, you'll see a page that looks like this. You enter your name and email, and you can be immediately taken to my free training where I can show you how to embody the changes versus intellectually understand it, but still have your experience not change or be the same. Now, the first emotional trait that you can step into and start embracing, if you want to open up his eyes, his heart, his focus on you, which is the first thing that needs to happen before he falls in love, he needs to notice you. He needs to feel you, is optimism and aliveness. And this seems like such a corny thing. Most people overlook it. Most people even talk about toxic positivity, which is a real thing, don't get me wrong. But I'm talking about right now living in a time and place where there's so much fear, anxiety, pain, bad news, and the focus of most human beings around us is far more stressed now than at probably any other point in history in terms of all the bad information we're sensing and feeling from on our phones, on our TVs, on our computers, everywhere. Social media. So if you are someone who has found a way to not just fall in love with your life and to do the activities that make you feel happy and healthy and vibrant and have the courage to express it, and you have the vision of someone who sees a cup and it's half full versus half empty, it matters now more than ever. Because the last thing you want is someone who is focusing on the problem more than the solution or why it can't be done instead of finding the way to make it happen. So the first trait is your sense of aliveness and optimism will punch him in the heart stronger these days than at any point in history and can help you stand out. Second, and this is so important, if you were to hear nothing else, maybe this one would do it for you. It's healthy attachment. We've gone from a place where we talk about women, let's say 100 years ago, that in an unhealthy way needed men for pretty much anything. They didn't work, they didn't drive, he would make decisions for you, right, or your ancestors. And that's an unhealthy level of neediness, to the point where life has convinced you that you need to be fiercely independent and do everything on your own, that you don't need anyone to create happiness and fulfillment, which I think is untrue. We have been born and with a DNA that favors community, that favors connection, that favors healthy attachment. So when a guy connects with you and he feels the sense that you don't need him in any way and that you have convinced yourself that your life will be just as great without him than with him, then he feels something's off and he wants to connect with somebody else who has a healthy attachment towards him versus the sense of, I don't need you, and if you're in my life, it's great. If you're not in my life, I'm equally great, which is not true. Think about it. There's so many challenges that take place in a relationship, from things you have to sacrifice, to needs you have to express, to challenges you have to understand, so much cooperation needed. So if your life really will be just as great without a guy, if you don't need a guy, then I would suggest don't step into a relationship. If you know in your heart of hearts that you do need a guy in some way to grow more than you will on your own, to meet certain parts of your well-being in ways that you really can't do on your own, in a mountain, meditating by yourself, then when you connect with men, make sure that your fierce independence is balanced, and that while you want to do things on your own, that you understand that 1 + 1 = 5, not 2. Number 3, which goes hand in hand with number 2, is vulnerability. Stepping into vulnerability will allow you to be more human and allow him to be more human. Here's what happens when you open your heart and you share your needs, your wants, and your fears with him. He all of a sudden opens his heart with empathy to receive you, if he's a healthy guy, and can do the same. He can start opening his heart to you and sharing things that maybe he wouldn't have shared. But now that there's this connection, now that he understands you're real with him, that you're human with him, that you have faults and you have needs, he feels more courageous to express them to you, which means when he opens his heart to you, not just to receive you, but to express himself, he starts falling in love. He feels understood. He feels seen. He feels witnessed. And that's a big component in this biochemistry of falling in love with someone, feeling understood, seen, and opening your heart to receive and to give to someone things that you do not share with the majority of the world. Number 4 is playfulness. Because I think that when you have not experienced what you want for a while, when you have been burnt time and time again by guys who can't go the distance, or by you choosing men who feel attractive to you but don't have the sustenance of making it work, because it goes both ways, it's not just his fault, you sometimes have chosen and stayed with guys that are not good for you. When that takes place, the common experience is that next time you start doing things, you become a little too serious about it. You go all into the depth of it. You go all into the hard questions, which need to happen, but not without the playfulness and the fun and the joy and the spontaneity that comes. So if you're someone who has taken this too seriously, yes, continue taking it seriously, but infuse on it an air of playfulness and spontaneity and fun. Don't think of yourself in such a serious way, because then it's one-sided. There's much more depth when there's a range, and the range between playfulness and depth is something that really punches guys in the heart in a good way, where they now start seeing you as someone different and unique, which leads me right to my next trait, number 5, authenticity expressed. So many women have unique traits that make them. But maybe there's a way of singing. Maybe there's a type of movie they want to watch. Maybe there's a game they like to play, or a combination of a few things. But because they have been judged in the past by others, because they feel it's a flaw rather than a strength, they shy away from expressing those deep, quirky, dorky even, parts of themselves with men. And that endearing component of a relationship, where not only are you human, but you have things that no one else has just like you, you become more vanilla, you become more plain, you become more boring. So what I'm saying to you right now is those parts of you that you've been afraid of showing because you feel like if somebody were to see them, they would judge them, I'd love for you to start expressing them more, because ultimately you want for the guy to be with you, to be with you for who you are versus who you're trying to pretend to be so that he continues liking you. So if the guy doesn't enjoy your humming, or doesn't enjoy something that makes you you, then perhaps he's not the right guy for you. Next one, number 6, is directness. Okay, ladies, here's where I have to step in and share something that might really save you from so much pain. You, in your infinite capacity to feel, and sometimes express, and sometimes create, can think of so many different things when you want to communicate a message to him. And guys, although they will hold space for you to understand you and to hear what you have to say, when you have something important to share, be as clear and direct as possible I'm not saying there's no space for you to open your heart and ramble for an hour expressing all the thoughts and feelings you have. That's needed sometimes. And you just need to let him know that that's what you're doing so he doesn't freak out or doesn't know how to respond to you or tries to fix problems as you start expressing them. But separate point, when you have the capacity on things that matter, instead of dragging it along and saying, we're going to have this conversation and introducing the theme and the plot and the characters, you say, here's what I need. Clear out. Go from the start. Start with the end in mind. Express what your need is and then embellish it with more words. The clear and direct communication you can have with them will help him understand what you want, what you need, and also know that he's able to deliver it versus be lost in an ocean of feelings that he may not know how to deal with in a way that your girlfriends will. Last one is sexual expression. I left it to the last because although that's something that you're not going to express with a guy until there's an exclusive relationship, at least in my way of thinking, that's something that's really important. There's two components to sexual expression. The first one is your capacity to understand what you need and what you want, what makes you happy and fulfilled, because if that's not taking place, he's going to be shooting a dart in the darkness and not know when he hits and when he doesn't. So you need to come at this, or ideally come at this, from a place of you know what you want, what makes you happy, what makes you unhappy, how you like to be touched, how you like to be made love to. That's the first component. So you can guide him and direct him in the right place. The second part of this is your capacity to lose yourself in the moment and allow him to take you places, if he's a good lover, that you can't take yourself on your own. Because when those two components happen, when you are clear in expressing what you need so he can deliver it, and then you allow yourself to experience it, you're not in your head anymore, you're as expressed as you need to be, he gets to feel a level of connection with you, especially when all the other emotional needs are in place, that makes him fall in love with you. Hope this is helpful, useful, and insightful. If it is, I'm going to ask you to do one thing. If you want to take these concepts further and embody the change instead of just think the change, hit the first link in the description of this video, enter your name and email, and start watching my free training right away. If you like this video, click like or thumbs up, subscribe to my channel. When you click the little bell, you'll be notified of new episodes. Let me know what you liked about it on a comment. And last but not least, if you've been listening to my videos and other people's videos, if you've been reading blogs, you've been doing the law of attraction, you've been having shamans clear your aura, and you're still not getting the connection you want, there might be a gigantic benefit in you getting help. And if you want my help to experience this, second link in the description of this video will allow you to apply to work with me. Thank you for allowing me in your heart. Thank you for allowing me in your feed, in your home. And as always, I challenge you to live a full and conscious life.